You, never before have we pondered a subconscious connection with the contents of an uncracked egg. But there, essay first time for everything. In this case, you, 4x4 is the shell and we, re its quivery innards. Practically foaming as the big Vanteater totters up and down a craggy off-road course outside of the Ladson, South Carolina, facility where U.S. market sprinters are assembled. Our squishy sensitivities aside, this is the ideal first encounter with the Sprinter's newly available four-wheel drive system, which has been offered on global models for some time but is only just reaching our shores for the 2015 model year, U, for an extra $6,500. Any Sprinter body style, passenger, crew, cargo, in either wheelbase length, 144. 3 or 173 inches, can be equipped with four-wheel drive and a nifty 4x4 badge. Add another $300 for a low-range transfer case with a 42% lower crawl ratio. To get four-wheel drive, buyers must also order the 188 HP V6 turbo diesel and 5-speed automatic. The 4-cylinder turbo diesel 7-speed automatic that joined the U remains rear drive only. A push of a button switches the van from a 2-wheel drive hauler into a 4-wheel drive off-roader that just happens to carry a massive volume of stuff. On Sprinters so equipped, a second button press activates low range. In either 4x4 mode, 35% of torque is routed to the front axle while the other 65% powers the rear. Unlike Mercedes-Benz S4 MATIC all-wheel drive, the torque split isn't variable, so it's best to leave the Sprinter in two-wheel drive mode on dry pavement unless you enjoy the sounds of binding driveline components. Unfortunately, the pre-production Sprinter 4X4S weren't registered for street use, but a brief trip on pavement confirmed that, with four-wheel drive switched off, the 4X4S drive more or less identically to their two-wheel drive counterparts on Benz's Mini Rubicon. However, single quote,